गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास सेवन चिल्ड्रन, होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल। सो चिल्ड्रन, इन माय लास्ट वीडियो आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू फ्यू एक्टिविटी नंबर 1, 2 एंड 3 बेस्ड ऑन द फोटोसिंथेसिस प्रोसेस। ओके, फ्यू एक्सपेरिमेंट्स। सो द मेन प्रोसेस इन ऑल द एक्सपेरिमेंट्स वॉज स्टार्च टेस्ट, और यू कैन से आयोडीन टेस्ट। ओके, सो विच कंटेन 4 steps। फर्स्ट वन इज वी शुड बॉयल लीफ इन बॉयल वाटर। सेकेंड स्टेप, वी शुड बॉयल इन इथेनॉल। देन वी शुड वॉश इट विथ हॉट वाटर और प्लेन विथ हॉट वाटर। एंड द फोर्थ स्टेप इज स्टार्च टेस्ट, ओके, विद द हेल्प ऑफ आयोडीन सॉल्यूशन। सो चिल्ड्रन, रिमेंबर these all 4 steps are very important. So based on these experiment, I have explained you activity number 2, oxygen 1 also, activity number 3 also. Now today I am going to explain you activity number 4, which indicates or which shows that chlorophyll is very necessary or very important for photosynthesis. It is one of the condition, okay, that photosynthesis is also very important for photosynthesis. In the absence of chlorophyll, what will happen? Photosynthesis process will not take place. Okay, plant won't be able to produce their food which is in the form of glucose, which is then converted into starch. Okay, so in this activity we will check whether chlorophyll is important and how it is important. So for this activity we need few materials. As you can see, potted plant with variated leaves. Variated leaves means, children, variated leaves means half green and half brown leaves. Okay, two different kinds of leaves. Leaf can be green or red, green or yellow, green or brown, anything. So for this we need a coleus plant, either coleus plant leaf or croton leaf. Okay, so these plant leaves are usually variated. Okay, now for this we need burner, test tube, dropper, petri dish, water, paper, sketch pen. So main ingredients or materials are alcohol or iodine solution. These are the reagents we need. Okay, now what is the procedure and why we use pen and sketch pen here? So let me explain you. So first, what we should do, we have to take a potted plant of coleus or croton plant which has variegated leaves. Okay, variegated means half green and half yellow or brown. Now we have to keep it, this plant, into under the sunlight for few hours. Okay, then we have to pluck a leaf from this plant, either coleus, either croton. Now then sketch the shape on the white paper. So with that paper and sketch pen, what we will do, we will trace the leaf. Okay, we will trace, you know, tracing, in drawing you do tracing, the same thing you have to trace the leaf. You have to trace the size of the leaf, pattern of the leaf, which part of the leaf is green, which is brown, which is yellow. That patches you have to sketch with the help of this sketch pen and plain paper. Okay, then it is written, mark the green and non-green area by sketching. Okay, on the paper you have to draw as it is, you have to sketch the leaf. Okay, now after that you have to do protein test, starch test. So how you will do the starch test? By following the 4 steps. First one, we will boil the leaf in boiling water. Okay, so what will happen if you will boil the leaf? I have explained you in my last video, it helps us to kill the cells. Okay, and all the, it will destroy all the enzymes also. Okay, so then we have to boil in ethanol or methanol, which is an alcohol. Okay, so what this alcohol will do, this alcohol will remove all the green part. So suppose this leaf is half green and half yellow. Okay, so half part of the green or chlorophyll content will remove with the effect of this alcohol. Okay, so this is the second step. Third step, then we have to what we should do, we should do again to after treating with alcohol, the leaf will become hard, so we have to soft it, we have to make it soft, we have to dip in hot water, and that is a third step. And with the effect of hot water, what will come, extra alcohol will come out from the leaf. Okay, now then last step is, as this boy is doing, we have to add a few drops on the leaf. We have to add on the green part also and yellow part also. So we have already traced the leaf. Okay, so we know where is the green part, where. So you have to, as you can see on the full, this boy is spreading iodine solution on the full leaf. Okay, or the, or you can say on the margin of the leaves. Okay, so when after doing this, what will happen, we can see the result. Okay, which indicates the green part which is already traced, you can match from the paper the green part, wherever you have traced the green part, that will look like blue black, and rest of the part will remain pale white or brown only. Okay, means non green. So this is the activity. Okay, so in this for chlorophyll condition, to check the chlorophyll condition, what we should need, we should need a variegated leaves of Coleus or Croton. Okay, fully green leaf we will be unable to see the result. Okay, accurate result. So that's why we are taking the variegated leaf. Variegated means different. Okay, different color leaf. Now observation I am reading for you. In our observation it is written that the reason marked green in the sketch shows blue black color with iodine, so we can easily see. Okay, and the non-green reason remains unchanged. It means starch is present in the green leaf which turn into blue black, and other part will remain unchanged. Okay, so what is the conclusion, what is the result? Conclusion means result. Okay, so what is the result? So result is, chlorophyll is important for photosynthesis, essential for photosynthesis. Okay children, steps, remember the first four steps. Okay, boiling, which kill the cells, and make permeable the leaf to absorb the iodine solution. Okay, now next activity is, in this activity we will check whether the sunlight is essential for photosynthesis or not. So as you know, it is very important, this condition is also very important, sunlight one. So for this, what we should do, so in my last video I have explained you de-starching means we have to keep for few hours, for 3 days or for 48 hours we have to, or 24 to 48 hours we have to keep potted plant into the dark room or dark area. Okay, so that it will utilize all the starch. Okay, we should not show under the sunlight that potted plant. So that process in which we are just keeping for 48 hours the potted plant, that process is called de-starching. Okay, so in this also we will do that same thing. So you can see the procedure, it is written, these are the material required that we need. Main thing, we need a clips and paper clips, black paper, or we can take the chart paper, black chart paper, and clips. These are the main thing. Okay, and rest are common materials. Now procedure I am reading, keep a green potted plant in a dark room. As I said, our first aim is for this activity is to de-starching the plant. Okay, so first we will keep it up, this plant, in the 48 hours so that plant will utilize its or remove it starch. Okay, which is a food. Okay, now pluck one leaf and test this. So we have to, from this de-starch plant, we have to pluck one leaf and we have to confirm the test. Okay, whether, now for what we should do, for that leaf we will cover the middle part, as you can see in the first picture. Okay, this middle part, and we have to cover from front side also, from the back side also, we have to cover it with chart paper, and we have to place the clips like this from all the four sides. So you can see we have to cover the middle part with the clips and the chart paper. Okay, on both the side. It is written, mentioned also. Okay, so place this plant in sunlight. So after discharging, what we have to do, we have to cover this leaf part, middle part, and again we have to keep it sunlight, okay, under the sunlight for few hours. Okay, then just pluck this leaf and perform the starch test by doing the all the four steps. First is that the same step, boiling with water, boiling with alcohol, then with soft boiling water, third step, and fourth step, the same, add iodine solution. Okay, so you will see after doing that starch or iodine test, what you will see, that middle part which we have covered, okay, it will not turn into blue black, and rest this upper and lower part will turn, this green part, this exposed green part will turn into blue black, okay, because you know this black chart paper will act as a opaque object. You know, in class 5, I have explained you what is transparent, what is translucent, what is opaque object. So you know, children, I have just as you know in the physics also, that what are opaque objects which do not allow light to pass through. The same thing, this black chart paper here act as a opaque object. It will not allow sunlight. When we will just keep this plant under the sunlight, it will not allow sunlight to enter in the middle portion of the leaf. Only the exposed upper and lower part will get the sunlight, and in this part only photosynthesis will take place, and in the middle part it will not take place because sunlight is not there. Understood, children? So this is the same test only. Observation I am just reading for you. The uncovered part of the leaf that was exposed to sunlight turned blue black, as we can see upper and lower part, while the part of the leaf which was covered with black strip or black chart paper, which is the middle part, you can see, will remain unchanged, okay, or you can say the gray and all, not blue black. Okay, now conclusion is, this shows what it will show, this upper and lower part will contain starch, whereas this middle portion do not contain starch. Okay, so sunlight through this activity also, this black paper, we can see this photosynthesis is very important for photosynthesis. Okay, sunlight is important for photosynthesis. Now children, next one is activity number 6. Okay, so you know, few materials are common in all the activities. When you will see that activity number 2, 3, 4, okay, or few like iodine solution, alcohol, all these are common. Okay, now here, this in this activity we will check whether the CO2, carbon dioxide, is important for photosynthesis or not. So materials we need a 2 potted plant of same size, you can see, of same species, you can take 2 glass plates where we will keep the plant. So this lower you can see plate, 2 bell jars which is covered, so this jar is called bell jar. Okay, now we want watch glass, so this is a watch glass where we will put the chemical, and then we need a KOH solution, potassium hydroxide solution, KOH. We need a grease so that we can make a setup, airtight setup. Okay, we can give the airtight setup. So we have to grease all over this portion. Okay, then iodine solution through which we can only test the starch. Okay, so what is the procedure? Step by step I am reading for you. Take 2 healthy potted plants of almost same size and mark A and B, as you can see in the diagram. Okay, children. Now, destarch them by keeping in dark room for 2 to 3 hours. So, 48 hours or 2 to 3 hours. Again, we have to keep these plant into the dark room. Okay. So, what is the purpose of dark room? To remove all the starch. Okay. In the dark room, because there will be no sunlight. So, these plants will unable to make their food. So, what they will do? They will use that food also. Okay, the stored starch food only they will utilize. Okay, they will not able to make their food. That's why we have to finish द स्टार्च कंटेंट फ्रॉम देयर प्लांट बॉडी पार्ट. ओके सो दैट्स वाई वी आर डूइंग डी स्टार्चिंग. ओके चिल्ड्रन, नाउ देन थर्ड स्टेप इज place these potted plants A and B to separate glass plate. So you can see two glass plate, one is here, one is here. Now water them and cover them with separate bell jar. So we have to give the water, okay, and we have to cover it. Now with plant A, place a watch glass containing potassium hydroxide. So formula, chemical formula of potassium hydroxide is KOH. It is written here. Okay, K means potassium, OH means hydroxide. So in A only, in the watch glass, we will keep the KOH solution. In the B, we will not keep KOH solution. Remember this setup. Okay. Now, what is the tendency of KOH? KOH is a chemical which absorbs the CO2, which has tendency to absorb the carbon dioxide gas. Okay, children. So remember this. Now, then what we should do that after placing, use grease. So on the margin of this lower margin where plate is there, where bell jar is there, this corner, we have to seal it with grease. Here also and here also. All these lower edges, free edges, because we have to not allow even air also to enter inside the bell jar. Okay, sunlight can pass because these bell jar are transparent. So they can easily pass. Okay, carbon dioxide is also already present in the this area. Okay, inside the bell jar it is empty, so air is there, so carbon dioxide plant will take. Okay, sunlight it will get, water we will provide, we have added water, then only we will cover the bell jar. So and chlorophyll is already present inside the leaf, so plant is getting all the four conditions for photosynthesis. All right children, so after doing the airtight setups, okay, we have to place these sunlight for 2 hours. Okay, for 2 hours we have to keep both the setup under the sunlight. Now then we have to, after 2 hours we have to pluck a leaf, one leaf from this setup, A setup, one leaf from B setup, and then we have to perform the starch test by following all the four steps. Okay, first with the boiling water, second with the alcohol, third with the normal again water, so that to leaf will become soft and it will remove extra alcohol, and fourth with the iodine solution. Okay, so children, you will see the leaf from A plant shows absence of starch. So the leaf of A plant will not show blue black color, it will remain brown, but leaf B will turn into blue black. Why? Because you know here we have kept KOH solution. So when we are doing airtight, okay, and KOH solution is there. So KOH solution, I told you, I have explained you that KOH solution has the tendency to absorb the carbon dioxide. So in the A setup, KOH is there. So KOH will absorb all the CO2 content that is present or that is present inside the this bell jar. Whereas no KOH is there, so in the B setup plant will produce or perform the photosynthesis, okay, and they will synthesize the starch and they will give positive starch test. So the setup B leaf will turn blue black, whereas setup A leaf will not turn into blue black because of this KOH solution which absorbs the carbon dioxide gas. Okay children, so I am reading the observation because it is written the leaf from A plant setup shows absence of starch, no blue black color, whereas leaf from B plant B test positive, it will turn the leaf blue black. Okay, why? What is the inference? Inference means result. What will be the result? CO2 was not available to plant A because potassium hydroxide absorbed all the carbon dioxide from the air of bell jar, hence no starch was formed. This shows that carbon dioxide is important for photosynthesis. Children, in this note, whenever I am explaining you and I am reading any sentence, you just mark with pencil in the book. Okay, so this observation and inference of all the activities are very important, so you just underline you will read the observation and inference, you will get that why this activity is going on, why what happened in this activity. So you will get the idea. All right, children. So these observation and inference you should underline. Okay. Now, children, there were only six activities. Okay, so in my I hope you understand. Now in our homework, read the chapter. Okay, and whatever is you have any doubt, whatever is your doubt, please keep it marked, write somewhere. Okay, now children, thank you and have a nice day. In my in next video, I will discuss book exercises and question answers. Okay, children. So thank you and have a nice day.